and they're off. Breaking out pretty quickly, Mokotil down the center. Mountain Peak is showing speed. Also showing a lot of speed is One Night Stand, trying to cut across with the Thin Blue Line, and they're chased by Silky Wilkie. Away to the far side, Recon Mission is showing great dash, and Sampa's Seven now coming through in the noseband, probably to lead overall. They're chased by Mountain Peak and Zarzini and Novello on the far side. Then behind these, Angleland in an orange jacket, Lord Ridderford further back, trying to make ground. Vintage Clarets under the stands rail as they race on now inside the final two furlongs. Recon Mission in the center, right down the center too is Clarendon House. This one probably leading now. It's Clarendon House that's gone on from One Night Stand. Novello is running on strongly behind those Silky Wilkie inside the final furlong. Clarendon House is now being claimed by Novello on the far side. Near side Silky Wilkie. Novello! Novello has won the dash. Clarendon House and Silky Wilkie fighting it out for second. Zarzini doing well on the near side. Mokotil running on, and So Too Papa Don't Preach on the far side.
And it's the second winner at the Betfred Derby Festival for George Bowie. Novello has won the dash. And we can't say that you didn't tell us, because you laid out the case in full, in detail, here yesterday.
Yeah, look, he's it has been quite a long-term plan for him. And he likes fast ground. I think the stiff pace, as I said yesterday, would probably suit him. And it was a bit of a nervy last minute, but last furlong. But he's progressive, and he was still very immature last year. And I know he was an early two-year-old, but I was pretty keen to persuade Fiona to keep him in training, and you know, she brought the other shareholders out, and with this race in mind, so it's nice when the plan comes off.
And what was it that you saw that made you do that? It's sticking your neck out quite a bit, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. He was very mature physical, and he's still quite up behind, and you know, he hadn't fully grown, and he's not a big horse, but he just, to me, he looked immature. Kind of missed his, he won a race or two last year, but he didn't really go to the heights that I hope he might do this year. And no, so it was a bit neck on the line, but certainly worth it.
Tell me, you had an eye on him all the way through. What were your thoughts as the race developed?
Well, he travelled a bit better in the cheap pieces this time. He ran on Monday at Windsor, and it was a four-runner race. I never really thought the race would be suited to him, but he's a fresh horse who doesn't do much at home, and he does it on the track anyway.
And do you have a plan for him now?
Not really. I don't think there's anything at Ascot. We'll probably keep him at five. There's a race at Goodwood for him. Can't remember which it is. There's a handicap there for him. And I think a similar sort of configuration of track. You know, it's downhill, fast five, strong pace, probably suits him. So we might just wait for Goodwood.
Are you happy with your work over the 2 days?
It's been a good couple of days. Nice winner's circle to be in.
Good. Congratulations. Well done, George.
Thanks so much. Cheers.
And the man who delivered Novello to victory in the dash is Andrea Zeni. Congratulations. Last gasp in many ways to get his head up. Talk me through the race.
We you know, drawn five. We didn't think it was a deal at the time. You know, as you well know, on the five furlong straight, a lot happens towards the Sunside Rail. But I spoke with George before the race. He said, look, nothing we can do about the draw, and we just have to stay where we are and just hope for the best, really. He thought, you know, the five would have really suited him here, where they go hard, and you know, it's sort of stiff, quite a stiff finish as well. So, you know, on a going day, he's a decent horse, and he showed it today.
George is thinking about sort of sticking to these kind of tracks, so maybe a target at Goodwood. Do you think he was suited by going downhill?
Well, he came down the hill here quite nicely. I think what really suits this fella, it's a big field where they go quick and they get racing quite early. Like, he got beat the last day at Yarmouth in a five-runners race, which I'd say that wouldn't really suit to them. The time before he won the Thursk in a 12-runners race with or 14-runners or whatever, where they went a good gallop and came into it quite nicely. I do think these big handicaps will suit him better, although you need a lot of luck.
And do you feel there might there be more to come? Because George was saying that he persuaded the owner to hang on to the horse rather than let him go after his two-year-old year. Do you think there's a bit more to come?
I'd say so. It sounded like this race was a long plan for him, and so they had him, George and the team obviously had him spot on for the day. But you know, with these sprinters, they do get better, you know, with racing and with age. And you know, I know he only won a head or a short head, whatever he was, but he felt quite comfortable.
Going back to the Derby, it seems really weird that the Derby was race two, but reflecting back at the Derby, what happened with Dear My Friend?
Well, Dear My Friend, obviously, we were drawn one, and he sort of jumped and sort of let him find his feet, because he was a little bit keen with me and the Dante. Mm-hmm. And we didn't want him to do that the same again today. So he just sort of flopped coming out of the stalls. And we actually, halfway through the race, I didn't think the pace was overly strong. I had Ryan on my outside and actually the second horse in front of me. So we had a good pitch most of the way. Like I said, I didn't think the pace was overly strong, and then sort of when the pace lifted just before we turned into the straight, it sort of got left a little bit flat footed and it didn't come across the road as well as the others. He lost a bit of a momentum, and to be fair to the horse, he just sort of plugged on all the way to the line. He will win a nice race. I think he's a nice horse. Maybe back to 10 furlongs on a more of a flat track.
Okay. Thank you very much for your thoughts, Andrea. Congratulations with your dash win.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.
Subscribe to Racing TV's YouTube channel now to watch more great races like this.